The option to automatically modify the REVIT's model diameters using the PLUMBER Add-in has certain peculiarities that we would like to show you in this video. In this case, I have loaded the water distribution network model for an auditorium. When we created this network inside REVIT, we have tried to use a large diameter, say 1 or 2 nominal diameters above the one we assume will result from the calculation. We have done this to ensure that, when the add-in makes the sizes change, after the design is done, no problems arise due to the lack of space to locate fittings such as T's and elbows, among others. For example, take a look at this group of lavatories. Note that the 40 mm diameter that we have used in this pipe is surely excessive and, we assume, after the calculation is made, it will end up being less than this value. So let's see what happens when we go to calculate. And we activate, in addition to the option to internally determine the diameters. This option allows us to modify the sizes in the REVIT model automatically. The type of message shown has nothing to do, at least directly, with the add-in. These are error messages that REVIT generates because there is no space to place or modify the size of a specific fitting. Here, when I click to show, the visualization certainly does not help much, but we can see in any case that this small pipe segment in orange is the one that causes the problem since it is very short. We will click Cancel to allow the add-in to continue trying to modify the sizes. You will see similar messages continue to appear. Too short line. Now the message warns that a change would invalidate the connection. So, at any time, I click Cancel to prevent the add-in from making the corresponding changes. As you can see, a few will appear. Until finally, the message informing that the calculation was successful is shown. Let's see now what we have. Returning to the group of lavatories, as we imagined, it resulted in a smaller diameter than what we had drawn and, indeed, we do not have any inconsistency regarding sizes due to an error like the ones we previously saw. In fact, let's confirm. The diameter of the model is 15 mm. And, for the add-in, 15 mm too. It's okay. Now, let's look at the elbows here. Note that the pipe that arrives in the model is 50 mm. Like the one that goes down. But, the elbows, and this segment, remained at 40 mm. This was, surely, one of the points that generated an error when the add-in tried to modify the sizes. Note that if I manually try to modify the diameter of this segment to the necessary 50, the already known error is shown, since there is no space to place the reducers from the 40 mm elbows. But if I cancel here, and then try to modify the size of both elbows to 50, the error appears again since, obviously, there is no space to place the pipe segment that would interconnect them. So, as you can understand, situations like this are challenging to handle from the routines included in the add-in. Well, note that here the solution is to move this pipe to the right, to make the pipe segment in question longer. So let's move it a little bit. And I repeat the modification. Now I do manage to standardize the diameter. Of course, at this time, if we consider it necessary, we can bring the section closer to try to keep it as close as possible to its original position. We will find similar situations at the point of connection to the plumbing fixtures. Look at this water closet. The pipe that feeds it must have, by calculation, 40 millimeters. And, although the fixture's diameter in this model is 25, note that the reducer has been placed before the elbow. If I try to modify its size, we have the error again. Since there is no space to place the reducer in the pipe that connects to the fixture. So, a possible solution would be to move the fixture to be able, as you see, to modify the elbow's diameter to 40. It is, therefore, vital that you keep this in mind when drawing using the tools provided by REVIT. It is ideal to try to have diameters larger than those that would result from the calculation to minimize the appearance of these errors and, thus, allow the add-in to modify sizes more easily. Doing this, you will save much more work than the one you already save using the add-in in your designs.